more controversial remarks from Donald Trump on foreign policy. In an interview published today in the New York Times, he said that if elected, he might break America's long-standing commitment to NATO, which goes back to the 1940s. And that suggests that if a NATO member in the Baltic states were attacked by Russia, he may not intervene. It is a position which runs counter to the Republican Party platform. Speaking today on CBS This Morning, Newt Gingrich, who once favored the expansion of NATO, defended Trump's remarks.
First of all, countries ought to worry about our commitment. But they ought to worry about our commitment under any circumstance. Every president has been saying that the NATO countries do not pay their fair share, which is not just important about a financial thing. They can't do anything militarily.
Well, we're not doing this for the benefit of those countries. We're doing it for the benefit of America's interest in the world.
Right. So you have only two countries in the NATO alliance, other than the United States, pay 2% of their gross domestic product for defense. So you now have all of these people who are not doing their fair share. They can't militarily function. And they're saying that, which means that they're a source of weakness, not a source of strength.
That's fine. That's an argument to make. You know national security.
Right.
But to my point, do we base our foreign policy interests on whether somebody pays their bills, or do we base our foreign policy interests on what is best for America's national security? We're in Korea not because Korea is paying some bills. We're in Korea to contain North Korea and Kim Jong-il, not about whether somebody's contributing to some NATO alliance.
And if the South Korean government was as short-sighted and as lacking in seriousness as about half the NATO governments, we'd have to have a serious debate about whether or not we'd stay in Korea. You had the right question, but you assumed the answer. The right question is it in America's interest to sustain a relationship where after several presidents, now this is not, Bush was doing this. I was with Rumsfeld when Rumsfeld was making the same case. These guys have had 20 years to fix this. They refuse to fix it.
Specifically, the New York Times asked Donald Trump, if Russia came over the border into Estonia, Latvia, Lithuania, places Americans may not know about, but would we come to their immediate military aid? If you were president, would you come to their immediate military aid if Russia went into the borders of other countries?
I would think about it a great deal for this reason.
Before you would do it.
Estonia is in the suburbs of St. Petersburg. The Russians aren't going to necessarily come across the border militarily. The Russians are going to do what they did in Ukraine. 40% of Estonia is Russian. They're suddenly going to say we're being mistreated. They're going to have a militia. I'm not sure I would risk nuclear war over some place which is the suburbs of St. Petersburg. I mean,
wow.
I think we have to think about what does this stuff mean? Are you really...
So our treaties don't matter.
Our treaties have to be thought about carefully.